Hello everyone, I'm Dr. J. Meenakshi, doing my second year postgraduate in Department of Radio Diagnosis from Arupade Veeru Medical College and Hospital, Pondicherry. And I'm here to present my oral presentation on a case report on Cliven giant cell tumor. And coming to the introduction, giant cell tumor of bone is also known as an osteoclastoma, and it is very common, and the giant cell tumor are mostly benign, but it has a potential for malignant transformation. And the giant cell tumor of skull is very rare, and it can be found as an incidental finding on imaging for some other cause. And the lesions are located usually in the middle cranial fossa, affecting the following bones, namely temporal, sphenoid, petrosal and occipital bone, of which the sphenoid bone being the most commonly affected bone. And the common age group includes 20 to 40 years of age, and it can affect both male and female. And here is a clinical history of a patient, 25-year-old male, with a history of diminished vision in the eyes and also on and off headache. And the patient is not a known case of hypertension and diabetes, and he is not having any medical, surgical or trauma, recent trauma history in the past. Coming to the radiological imaging, the patient was taken up for CT imaging, and on axial non-contrast CT image, there is a soft tissue mass in the skull base involving the floor of the anterior cranial fossa. And the sagittal bone window showing an expansal lytic lesion, typically involving the clivus, and the lesion is showing a soluble appearance, which is favoring for the giant cell tumor. And on coronal CT image, bone window showing an expansal lytic lesion with the soluble appearance. And the patient was also taken up for surgery, which showing sagittal contrast MRI imaging, showing a large lesion of size 6x4 cm, which is centered on the clivus. And the lesion is also seen extending to the cellar and the paracellar region. Patient was also been investigated for blood counts, which includes the complete blood count at the biochemical blood test, which was found to be normal, and the physical examination was also found to be normal. And on neurological examination, patient was found to have optic nerve palsy. Coming to the management, patient was taken up for surgery, and the tumor was resected through endoscopic transnasal transsphenoid method, and the resected tumor was sent for histopathology. And on histopathology, the tumor showed fibrous collagenous tissue with scattered multinucleated giant cells within the stroma of spindle cells. Based on the clinical history, imaging, and histopathological finding, the diagnosis was concluded as giant cell tumor. As we discussed earlier, giant cell tumor of the skull and the clivus is very rare, and it occurs in less than 5% of population, and it is mostly found incidentally. And some patient may present with the symptoms like a headache, diminished vision or double vision. Some may be asymptomatic. Patient, when they are suspecting a giant cell tumor of the skull, should always be taken up for cerebral angiography, because the tumor is supplied by multiple small vessels. This cerebral angiography before surgery can help in controlling bleeding during surgery, because death may also occur due to massive uncontrolled bleeding. And identification of H3F3A mutation can also help in diagnosis of GCT of clivus, because there are many other clival lesions which help in differentiating. This mutation can help in differentiating other clival lesions. And the differentials can consider chordoma, skull-based chordoma and skull-based chondrosarcoma. But the chordoma, which is also centrally placed, which is well circumscribed, But the lesion has marginal sclerosis. And chondrosarcoma, here the lesion will have internal calcification. These are my references. Thank you.